One of the most important things that students can do in chemistry is memorize their polyatomic ions. This video, I'm going to give you a couple of tricks to help you work your way through memorizing it, because some students do have trouble. So when it comes to polyatomic ions, you're going to notice that there are a few endings you have to look out for. Eight and eight. Eight is the probably the most common ion you're going to come across. Eight is less common, but what happens is when you have these oxy ions or oxy anions, that's just negative ions with oxygen, the 8 always has one more oxygen than the 8. So an example, you have chlorate, ClO3-1, has one more oxygen than ClO2. So chlorate is ClO3, chlorite is ClO2-. Now, one less than chlorite is hypo, so which is 2 less than the 8. And then one more than 8 is per. So the order is per 8, 8, 8, and hypoite. Now, if you just remember one of these, and it's usually chlorate, if you remember that, you know the other three just because of the positioning and the last name. So one more than ClO3 is ClO4, which is per 8. And then one less than ClO3 is 8, and one less than that is hypoite. And this works for all group 17 oxyanions. So you could put bromine in there. BrO3- is bromate. BrO2 with the -1 charge is bromite. SO42-, well, that's going to be sulfate, which means SO32- is sulfite ion. That you just have to work on. That's how you figure out the number of oxygens. Now, a lot of students have difficulty with charge, and it took me a little while to realize this. Polyatomic ions exist because atoms contained in them have stable electron configurations. These are even numbers of electrons, so all the atoms, when they form a polyatomic ion, have an even number total. So if the total of the group numbers of the atom is odd, you need to add an odd number of electrons to make it even. So what we're going to do is we're going to figure out, it comes along with the valence electrons. If you have an odd number of valence electrons, you're going to need to add an odd number of electrons, thus an odd charge. So if you have an odd number when you add the total, you're going to have a charge of -1. Now the only one that's -3 is phosphate, so if you see phosphate, you just know it's -3. You just memorize that one. Anything else is -1 if it adds up to an odd number. And if it adds up to an even number, you're going to need to add 2 electrons, so the charge is going to be -2. And I'll take you through that in these examples right here. So, I have nitrate. Nitrate I know is NO3. Now let's figure out the charge. Nitrogen is in group 15. That's an odd group, so that's odd. Oxygen is group 16, that's even. So an even, 3 evens is still even, plus an odd is an odd. So this total is odd, which means the charge is going to be -1. Not convinced yet? Let's do bromate. Bromate's BrO3. And when we look at it, bromine's in an odd group. Oxygen's even, just like the other one. This one's -1 also. Because even 3 evens and an odd add up to an odd number. Phosphate, PO4, but that's phosphate. Phosphate's always 3-, the only one. So you just memorize that. Chromate, chromate's CrO4. Chromium's in group 6, that's even. Oxygen's in group 16, that's also even. 2 evens make it even. That charge is 2-. Cyanide. Cyanide's CN. Carbon's in group 14, that's even. Nitrogen's in group 15, that's odd. An odd plus an even is an odd, -1. Oxalate. C2O4. Carbon's in an even group, oxygen's in an even group. 2 evens make an even, 2-. Hydrogen carbonate. HCO3. Hydrogen's in group 1, that's odd. Carbon's in group 14, that's even. Oxygen's in group 16, those are evens. Even and an even plus an odd is an odd, the charge is -1. Hypochlorite, that's ClO or OCl. Chlorine's in group 17, that's odd. Oxygen's in group 16, that's even. Odd and even's an odd, -1. And that's how you can work, using your periodic table, you can figure out the charges. You pretty much have to, you're going to be on your own doing the names, figuring out the number of oxygens, but with a little practice, you should be good at it. You're always going to have a periodic table, so you should never make a mistake with the charge of a polyatomic ion. I hope that helps.